Good afternoon, and thank you very much for inviting me to open this important discussion. And first of all, I would like to express my appreciation and my gratitude to the Barilla Foundation, the Sustainable Development Solution Network, the Center for Sustainable Development at the Columbia University, and the Santa Chiara Lab of the Siena University. The presentation of the report Fixing the Business of Food has become a traditional feature of the General Assembly High Level Week. Italy is proud to be a supporter and a contributor to such an important discussion. The report is among the best examples of how the private sector and the scientific community can contribute in a substantial way to the implementation of the 2030 Agenda. This becomes even more necessary in the unprecedented situation caused by COVID-19. Fixing the business of food provides us with a unique perspective. From the point of view of the private sector, the report identifies a concrete set of actions and recommendations based on evidence and sound data analysis. Indeed, the four pillars framework is a sort of instruction manual to guide our efforts toward an active engagement of the private sector in the implementation of the 2030 Agenda. The publication of the 2020 edition of the report is particularly timely as the international community is responding to the crisis created by the virus. A health crisis, which has become very quickly a social and an economic crisis, affecting all aspects of our life. 2021 will be a crucial year, and we need all hands on deck to overcome this unprecedented crisis, especially in those sectors such as food security and nutrition, which are indispensable elements for the implementation of the whole set of the SDGs. In 2021, Italy will be entrusted with special responsibilities as the presidency of the G20 and co-president of the COP26 on climate change in partnership with the UK. Italy will also host the Global Health Summit, organized together with the European Commission. Moreover, we will play a central role in the Food System Summit as host of the Agri-Food UN Hub in Rome. People, planet, and prosperity will be at the core of the G20 vision as we plan to focus on a series of initiatives on food and security and nutrition-related issues. The four-pillar framework described in the report identifies a series of concrete policy options which could be further developed as Italy takes on these important responsibilities together with our international partners. Let me give you just a few examples. The first pillar, beneficial products and strategies. The engagement of the private sector in the promotion of healthy diets and sustainable production of food is core to the Italian approach to food security and nutrition as a key element for well-being and sustainability at large. Such an approach has a broader impact in terms of SDGs implementations due to its implication, among others, on health of the population, SDG 3, on the protection of environment and emission reduction, SDG 13, on water quality improvement, SDG 6, on land preservation, SDG 15, and on job creation, SDG 8. The second pillar, sustainable business operations and international processes. One of the elements that has emerged as central in the recent discussion in New York is the urgency to align public and private investment with the SDGs and the Paris Agreement. In the context of its G20 presidency, Italy will support the creation of a sustainability-related disclosure framework for both public and private investments, which will help increase transparency on available resources and on how they are used in terms of the SDGs implementation. A specific focus on human rights and equal opportunities is fundamental to ensure inclusivity and women empowerment. The third pillar, sustainable supply and value chains. The pandemic has further accelerated the need to change and adapt the supply and trading system to make it more resilient to exogenous shocks and to keep it free, fair and non-discriminatory, especially for micro, small and medium enterprises, the smallholders and the consumers who have been heavily impacted by the lockdown. We need to invest in innovations such as digital and logistic platforms. The engagement of the private sector is crucial to allow an extended access to all technologies and digital tools by the largest portion of business activities. And the fourth pillar, good corporate citizenship. The specific emphasis put on issues related to the rule of law and on the fight against illicit financial flows is particularly important. Italy will focus on initiatives aimed at extending the use of digital technology in tax administration as an accelerator for the recovery better. Digital filing mechanism, online refund procedures, greater use of withholding taxes should go alongside with investments in digital infrastructures as enabler for a more efficient and transparent management of private and public resources. So, to conclude, we are indeed at a turning point. Recovering better from the pandemic requires even more than before a transformative change toward a green, sustainable and inclusive economy. The 2030 Agenda and the Paris Agreement will continue to be the guiding stars of our action as we count on the synergies between government and the private sector, not only as a temporary fix for the crisis, but as a pillar for resilient societies. Thank you very much.